first of all, you know, being a part of this spot, you know, it was something that was so authentic to me, and you know, it was basically like, you know, you just do a workout, you go through your regular workout, and we just have a camera there and just capture, you know, capture your thoughts, capture your mind, and everything that brought you to this day. And a lot of the visuals seen in the spot is what drive me today. It's what made me who I am today. It's what continues to drive me. More than, you know, we hear championships a lot in our sport, and we hear individual accolades and so many things that drive you. But more than anything, for me, it's my hometown. You know, it's me remembering, you know, my house. You know, as you saw in the spot, 439 Hickory Street. You know, being tore down, you know, by the city, because we weren't financially able to continue to support it and to pay for it to stay up. And I remember that day like it was yesterday. It was very, it was a rough time for our family. It was a rough time for me. You know, just seeing our house being tore down, and you know, I just didn't know how we were going to be able to recoup from that. And you know, my mom, you know, basically, you know, waking me up, you know, many a times in the middle of the night, and telling me, you know, to pack your book bag, and you know, it was time to continue on our journey until we found something that we were going to be stable. You know, we're going to feel the most comfort. You know, so, you know, every day I'm working out or every day I'm playing basketball, I'm remembering these visualizations of me as a kid and going through what I went through and you know, going through the city and then ultimately moving to Spring Hill Apartments, 1180 Rentar Lane, apartment 602. And then finally having some sense of security, some sense of stability, you know, from that. And also at the same time, though, as you've seen in one of the vignettes, a kid opening the refrigerator and no food in there, and that adds to the struggle. It adds to the determination of saying, okay, you know how will I use this to, you know, to better myself as a young man? And you know, but as a kid, you really don't quite understand it. You feel like you should have everything, and you don't quite understand it, you know, long term. And I use that to this day as, you know, as my drive and my motivation. Just not having, you know, not being as fortunate as other kids or as other people, you know, either in my neighborhood, either in my, you know, my city or even my state. You know, all the way to seeing a vignette of me and my boys playing basketball at the outdoor court, you know, kind of bringing it together, you know, like we always did, you know, before we went out and played basketball, you know, on the outdoor court around a bunch of strangers. And we always said to ourselves, listen, we're going to go out and play no matter how old the guys are, how bigger, how fast, how stronger they are. You know, we feel like we, you know, we come together and play as one, and we can't be beat. And that led us all the way to, you know, it's crazy playing into high school and ultimately, you know, winning a national championship, you know, with the same crew that we kind of grew up with playing a game of basketball. And what that created for me was brotherhood and friendship that I didn't have growing up, you know, up until sports, you know, being a part of a single parent household and just being with just me and my mother. I always seek brothers or people that I could relate to around my same age group. And when I found those guys, Willie, Shion, Drew, you know, Romeo, you know, I already knew, you know, and I even had Brandon and Frankie on to that as well. You know, we knew that we were always going to be together one way, shape, or form, and do what we love to do, and that was to play sports. You know, and that still drives me, you know, knowing where we come from, knowing who, you know, where we all are today, even with our own respective families and respective things that we have to do as individuals, as men now, that drives me. You know, just knowing, you know, Without them, I probably wouldn't be in this position today. And, getting chills from hearing the narration of my mother's voice in the spot, saying, "Don't ever forget where you come from," and saying she's proud of me, and you know, and everything that she said about this city. The city of Akron is the birthplace of me, obviously, but it's like my father. You know, it's like my brother, it's like my mother, it's like my grandmother, it's like everything to me. It's just, you know, this city looked over me, it raised me to be who I am today. And I always said when I was a kid, if I ever made it to be respected or made it to a point where I had a voice of power, that I will always remember this city. I will always talk about this city, and people would know where this city existed, where this city was, what was this city, what this city brought, and who came from this city, because it was just, you know, the basketball courts that I played on, the streets that I walked, the schools that I went to, the football fields that I played on, you know, the classrooms and the classmates over the years that I had, and everything, and so on, all the way from, you know, the beginning of time to me rounding 30, it molded me. It molded me to who I am today. So, you know, to be able to do a spot and for Beach to kind of understand what I wanted to get out to the people, and for my fans and for everyone to see, that's what it's all about for me. You know, it's not always about championships or about money or about cars and clothes or about fame or about anything else. It's, for me, it's more about my upbringing, my trials and tribulations, my everyday struggles as a kid. Times where I had low self-esteem, times where I didn't believe that there was a way out, times where I didn't believe that tomorrow wasn't going to happen. Always looking for some type of help. And that kind of always, you know, resonated to my city because it gave me mentorship from little league coaches. It gave me the most powerful woman in my life, my mother. It ultimately gave me my wife, and my kids. It gave me sports, it gave me basketball. And you know, that's basically what the spot is all about. And, to all my fans that had an opportunity to check this out, I just wanted to break it down for you guys and let you guys get a little more of an insight on, what it is to be me. And to bring this Power Beast 2 wireless spot even more to life. So I appreciate you guys for checking this out, for tuning in, and hopefully I can continue to be that inspiration to y'all.